Hello everyone, welcome back to Rice City class, and this is video number 16. Hope you all are fine and safe. So did you study the topics which we have discussed in the last class? I hope it is so. So what all things we have studied in the previous class? We have started our fourth chapter, and the chapter name is programming. And we studied what is programming, how we can define the programming. A set of instructions that given to the computer is called a program. The software, different softwares like GIMP, LibreOffice Writer, LibreOffice Calc, they all are working by using these programs. And also we have studied about one important programming. We familiarized that, and it is known as Python programming, and we will be using this Python programming throughout this chapter. And for doing this Python programs and all, we need a platform, and it is known as IDE, Integrated Development Environment. And we are using for Python, the IDE is IDLE, Integrated Development and Learning Environment. And also we studied about translators. Translators means what? Computers will only know about the binary language or machine language, which consists of zeros and ones. So we the input which we are giving as the program, every programming there will be a translators, and the translators will convert our program, language, to the binary language, so that the computer can process the data. So today we will be doing some activities. In the last class also we have done one activity of printing one statement. We have print one statement name Amina. First we have done it in a terminal, and we use the translator. Some of the translators are Python 2, Python 3, like that. So we have used that translators, and we saw the how the computer is converting it into binary language, and we got the output. So, and after that we studied about the an IDE, Integrated Development Environment, and for Python we are using IDLE. We studied how to open IDLE, how we can open IDLE, application, programming, IDLE. So after that, when we open IDLE, you can see the Python shell. So there also we typed the string print of Amina, and directly without the using of this, without writing the step for translators, we got the output. So why there is no translators needed? Because inbuilt, by default itself, the translators are there in the IDE. So I hope it is clear to all of you. So today we will be doing two programs. One is the first activity, practice program functioning in Python shell, and the second one is let's find area. So how we can practice these all commands, these all programs? So for that we have to open our IDLE, application, programming, IDLE. So this is our Python shell. So here I am going to type, you can see here in page number 47. Just a second. I will open the textbook so that it will be easy for you to understand. Okay, so this is the program activity, practice program functioning in Python. So for I am going to type this all strings, and we have to note here how the output will be coming. So for that I am opening the IDLE. This one, this is the Python shell. So first one is print of welcome, so automatically the output is given here. So next we are going to type print of 1, 2, 3, close inverted commas. When we click on enter, you can see the output 1, 2, 3. So what is this comment means? Print of 1, 2, 3, we have to display 1, 2, 3 as the output on the screen. So we got that answer. The next one is print of 1, 2, 3. We got the answer. The next one is print 8 plus 9. Print of 8 plus 9. So they have calculated 8 plus 9, and we got the answer as print 17. So they have displayed that. Another one is print 8 plus 9, close. So what you can see the difference here, what difference you can notice here, it is of the same comment, but we have given it in a separate form. That means first is print of 1, 2, 3, this is the string. So it is displayed over here, and here there is no inverted commas in the second comment. 1, 2, 3, the same 1, 2, 3 is displayed here. Third comment is print of 8 plus 9. So here 8 and 9 is calculated. They have added 8 and 9. We got the answer as 70. And as the fourth comment, we have taken 8. 8 is one. It is one digit. It is separate, and 9. It is also separate. So there is no calculation is happening. Just they have written 8, 9. For what means? That means we have to print of 8. Along with 8, we have to print 9. So that is the answer. Print 8, 9, because this 8 and 9 is separate. So there is no that it does not mean that this 8 plus 9. That means addition. It is separate. 8 is separate and 9 is also separate. So the plus means we have to write 8 and 9 together. In this comment, plus means we have to write 8 and 9 together. In this comment, this plus means adding 8 and 9. So I hope it is clear to all of you. When we are when we put this 8 in a separate in a inverted commas and 9 in a separate inverted commas, we have to write it separately. That means we have to, when we that means we have we already wrote 8. After that, along with that, we have wrote the 9 also. Okay, so instead of adding, this plus sign means together we have to write 8 and 9. Okay, so I hope it is clear to all of you. So this is the first activity, 4.2, practice program functioning in Python shell. So here you can notice the output in the table. In this table you can notice the, sorry, you can note all the output of this comment. So next we are going to study another activity, activity 4.3. Imagine, just a second. So I will be closing this. Okay, so imagine that you need to find the total area of the playground in your school. We all are having in a school, there is playground. So if I want to find the area of the playground in your school, how we will be doing it in max? We will take the length and the breadth of the playground and we will multiply so that we will be getting the area. So how we can do this program in computer? You have found the length and breadth of the playground. What should be done to find its area? Shall we give instructions for this to the computer? Suppose the length is 8 meter and the breadth is 60 meter. So don't you want to find the area? If the variable L length is considered as the length and the variable B is considered as the breadth, we can consider L is equal to 80 and B is equal to 60. In max we can directly multiply 80 into 60, so that we will be getting the area. But for computer will not directly know what is this area and how to calculate that. So what we have to do is we have to store this value 80 to a variable L, the short form of the length L. In the same way, we have to store the breadth value 60 to the variable B. That means the short form of the B. Here you can see variables can be used to collect data. Variables can be indicated using either letters or words. Numbers and strings can be taken as values for the variables. So for computer, we can directly give found the area. We can directly write the program for to find out the area. So we have to store the values. We have to inform the computer we have given these values and we have stored these values in these variables. So for finding the length 80, the value is 80 and we have stored it in a length L, and the 60 value is stored in the breadth B, the short form of the breadth B and short form of the length L. If we indicate the area also must be stored in a variable A. Okay, the area with the variable A, then A is equal to L star B. Okay, in max we will directly calculate the values, but here we have to store the values. After that only we have to calculate the values. So how can we write this as a Python program? Here you can see in L I have stored the value 80, in B I have stored the value 60. The next one is A is equal to L star B. I am multiplying the L into B. Here for multiplication we have to type the type on the key star. So L star B, and here the answer of this L, when we multiply L and B, we will be getting an answer in value. That value we have to store in A. That means the short form of area A. And after that we have to print that A. Then only the answer will be displayed. So we have to tell these all things to the computer, and we can write these steps. Before writing a program, we have to write what things we have to do. So we can name it as algorithm. The steps that we are writing to get a program is known as the algorithm. Okay, so that will be later we will be studying. So let's see how we can run this program. Okay. So for that, I am opening our IDLE, application programming IDLE. So here in Python shell, I am not writing the program, because you know in Python shell we can write only small programs. If we are getting large number of programs, that means if the syntax, the syntax means the programs lines, for finding the area itself you can see there are 4 or 5 lines of the program. So if we got that type of program, it will be better, it will be more good if you write it in a new text editor. Okay, we have to store such that kind of programs. So for doing that, we have to open a new text editor. And how we can open the text editor? From the file menu in the Python shell, took new file. So this is a new file. So here I am going to type that program. Okay, so what is that program? L is equal to 80. That means for the length L is equal to 80, I click on enter. B is equal to 60. Breadth I have given 60. After that I have to calculate L in L and B. I have to multiply L and B, and I have to store that value in another variable known as A, short form of area A. So A is equal to L star B. After that what I have to do? I have to print. Print means I have to display print of this area. Okay, so this is the program for finding the area of a playground in our school. So what we have to do, I already told this kind of programs we have to store. Okay, so for storing the programs, what we have to do, we have to save. From the file menu in the text editor, go to the option save. So here we can write program1.py. The extension is py. So I have saved this. After saving only we can see the output. In Python shell, when you click on enter, you will be getting the output. So in text editor, for finding the output, we have to go to the menu run, and in the run we have to check the option run module. So when I click on the run module, you will be getting the answer in Python shell. The answer is 4800. What they have told in the program, they have given the value 80 to the L, they have given the another value 60 to the B, that means length and breadth. After that, area they have found L star B, that means 80 into 60 is calculated here. And the answer we have told in the program, we have to print that answer. Which value we have stored in area, that means A, that we have to print. So the output will be 4800. 18 to 60, it is known as 18 to 60, the answer is 4800. So in this way we can find out the area by using programs in Python program. In this way, for writing the program, we have to give instruction to the computer. That means I am giving a value 80. So directly I can't give that value 80. I have to store that value in a variable. In the same way, I have to store the breadth value in a variable. After that, the result also we will be getting a value, that also must be stored in a variable, because the computer will not know about that. So we have to make familiarized about this to the computer, then only computer will process. So, but for calculations and all, computer no need of familiarization, because in computer there is arithmetic and logical unit that already we have placed in the computer, which do automatically the calculations. Okay, so this is the program. So I hope it is clear to all of you. So if you have any doubts, you must ask me. So what all things we have studied in this session? We have studied how to print different statements in Python shell, and also we typed that statements. We found the difference also. If we put the inverted commas, the result will be different. Okay, so that also we have found. After that, we have done an activity to find the area. So I hope it is clear to all of you. If you have any doubt, you must ask me. Those having a computer's practice activity, others note down the points. Okay. So see you in the next class. Thank you.